Welcome back to Star Trek Online, everybody. I am your host, the House Code Gamer. Today we are going to see Quark kill T'Keth and avenge untold millions. Roll the intro.
My apologies for the quality of the transmission. I'm contacting you on an encrypted frequency. I'm working on an important covert mission, and I could use your assistance. I can't go into the details over comms, but you should know, if we pull this off, it could change the course of the Hurt conflict in our favor. Meet with me on Deep Space Nine to go over the details. Come along. I've been asked to keep the details of the mission on a need-to-know basis, and right now, only you and I need to know.
No, absolutely not. This is your worst idea yet.
Do I need to remind you of the unwritten rule of acquisition, brother?
Rule zero. What the Negus wants, we acquire. Why me? Get an Eliminator to do it. Get 50. You can afford it.
You have connections with the Klingons. That and your Rom's second most trusted Ferengi.
What? Who's first? Nog? Pell?
No. Moogie.
Fine. Send her, then.
But, brother, you did such a great job of rescuing her before.
I also told your son to shoot me if I ever thought of doing something like that again.
That's right, you did. Well, don't worry. He won't.
That's not what I'm worried about.
We need this, brother. We can't hold off the Herc forever.
Alliance forces are spread too thin to help, Quark.
We need the Klingons, brother. Otherwise, we're doomed.
Insanity! You don't even know where the Iconian fleet is, Rom.
I don't, but Starfleet Intelligence monitors all major threats, including the Iconians.
Starfleet isn't in the habit of sharing classified data.
If we can get access to a security console, we can extract the data. We'll need to keep the security officer on duty occupied.
Leave that to me, husband.
All right, leader. The security officer on duty is a creature of habit. Comes in on her break every day without fail. Your job is to keep her occupied so Rom can get what we need from the security console. Do what you need to do. Smile, laugh at her jokes, whatever it takes.
Really, Quark? I'm not here to seduce your customers. You and I both know there's more than one way to work a mark.
Whatever you say, just don't mess it up. She'll be here any minute now.
You worry too much, Quark. I got this.
Woo! It's your lucky day, officer. You're the 10 millionth customer here at Quark's. Congratulations! You've just won a free drink and a free spin at the Davo table. Quark, why don't you pour the lucky winner a drink? What'll it be, Constable?
Oh, thanks. I'll take a nice drag to Gino. I'm on duty. I can't stay too long, but I suppose I have enough time for a spin at the table. Lead the way.
Quark, will you turn that hollow me off, please? It's creeping me out.
This is why I like the hollow leader. She doesn't complain as much as the original. There. Happy?
The free drink will get her to relax. And then some Dabo to keep her busy. One loss to remove suspicion.
Oh, looks like my luck's run out. Oh well, thanks for the drink and the spin. Better get back to my station.
Whoa, don't be so hasty, friend. The law of averages is on your side here. Trust me. Have another spin on the house. What have you got to lose?
Okay, you've convinced me. One more spin. Why not?
Then a victory to reel her in. Double!
Nicely done. Those winnings are coming out of your cut, though.
Good. The guard's distracted. Time to go to work. Overriding this door panel should be child's play. This is the most secret maintenance panel. Chief O'Brien needed me to fix it once. Once I'm in, I can install a back door. Then we can access the system from the console at Quark's.
She's heading back, Rom. Get out of there!
Relax, everyone. It's done. I'm on my way back.
Try not to look conspicuous or guilty.
Okay.
I can't believe you pulled that off. Being the Negus hasn't made you go soft between the lobes. Let's figure this out before security gets wise. Use the console behind the bar and find out what you can about the Iconians. Oh, and while you're at it, look for any other useful information in there, too. Some of it.
Relax, brother. I'll have these files cracked in no time. Starfleet encryption is good, but it's nothing compared to what we use in the Commerce Authority. That's actually difficult.
Intelligence officer's log, stardate 8900. Intelligence officer's log, stardate 88139.9. A large Vakiri fleet has been spotted in transit to the Gamma Quadrant. Analysis of their course suggests they're heading toward the Renegade Iconian fleet. Interesting. If the two of them manage to eliminate each other, well, that'll be two less headaches to keep me up at night. Intelligence officer's log, stardate 88039.8. Taket's fleet is currently in the Phoeban sector, moving through deep space. She's keeping a low profile for the most part, avoiding conflict with both the Dominion and the Herc. Anything foolish enough to get in her sights doesn't live long enough to regret it, however. The wreckage of a Gamma pirate flotilla will testify to that.
All right, Rom, a deal is a deal. You found the Iconian, so I guess it's my turn now. Time to put the team together? And that's the job. in front.
Where's Gala?
Really? He shot the hostage last time. He's not invited.
Brunt, your database skills should help us locate the package.
Always happy to help, Grand Nagus. Retreat.
Still a master of Rule 33, aren't you, Brunt?
It never hurts to suck up to the boss.
Of course. I presume you'll need my ship again, yes?
Not this time. We'll need a ship that can fight, just in case.
And we'll have it, thanks to our friend here.
Good. Everyone's here. Also, full consortium.
Ugh. Unbelievable.
The table's rigged. I'm sure of it.
Here we are. The cloaking device I acquired from my cousin Gala is working like a charm. Keep an eye on it, though. I'd rather not attract the attention of the Iconians, or the Fakiri, for that matter. Looks like they're busy trying to blow each other to bits out there. Let's use that to our advantage. You see those Iconian sentry probes? They use those to detect cloaked ships. So, you'll want to disable them before we move much closer. This cloak is good, but it's not that good. Getting in's the easy part. We're cloaked and unexpected.
Should be enough to get to the flagship undetected.
Well, we can all stop holding our breath now.
It worked.
If you'll be so kind as to fly us behind that massive Iconian ship, we'll be on our way.
I'm looking forward to this.
Almost there. Just take it nice and easy. I believe I'm actually going to sneak onto an Iconian flagship. Keep the engine running, okay? I have a feeling we're going to need to get out of here in a...
I've never been this close before. Impressive.
It's terrifying, more like it.
This is insane.
Nog, you're our engineer. Buy it 400 and sell it 5.
It'll be up to you to disable the security systems, son.
Right. I'm familiar with their tech from the war. I won't let you down, father. Evade.
We're up first, Nog. We need to lower the local security so Brunt and Leck can do their jobs.
No problem. I memorized the schematics for this vessel on the way here. There are engineering consoles we can use for that nearby. Follow me.
Head left here, Nog.
I've studied Iconian systems. I can unlock these doors. If I send in the appropriate signals to the door,
we'll have to disable security and engineering.
The good news is that my tricorder can get me the signal I need to send. The bad news is the Iconian systems only take trinary input. I think I see how the inputs work, so it shouldn't be too hard. Got it. And we're done here. Don't worry. I can handle that.
More than we can handle. Let Lek take care of it. He'll probably enjoy it.
Think I can lock the door behind once it's gone.
Great idea. Do that. Quickly! Head right here.
And we're done here. We've made it. This is Main Engineering. Security's offline. We're good to go.
Can we drop their rear shield for a moment?
From the other console? Why?
You'll see.
What's that, Uncle?
Call it an insurance policy. Lek, how do you feel about Iconian heralds?
Very dangerous. I look forward to shooting some. Sell it 250? Buy it 100.
You'll get your chance, clearing the path for Quark and Nog.
The riskier the road, the greater the profit. I'm in.
Lek, Brunt, you're on.
Brunt, FCA, I'm on my way.
The hunt is on. Magnificent, truly magnificent. It's looking this way between patrol points. I should be able to sneak up on it if I duck behind the walls. Ooh, they fight back. Good, good. I bet I could make that console explode remotely. Not the explosion I was looking for, but it'll do.
I found the package. The Iconian keeps it on display in what looks like a trophy room. And here I thought they were above such basic behavior. I've analyzed their patrol patterns, Lek. You'll need a clear path for Quark and Nog. I trust you'll keep the guards in that area occupied for a suitable period of time.
Testing my skills against Iconians? This is worth more than Latinum to me. Don't get your lobes bunched, Brian. front. I'll clear the path for the others by any means necessary. More enemies to the left, and another console. What? Still no explosion? Ugh, ridiculous. If I make some noise, the big one will come to investigate. This isn't work! This is fun! Overload those conduits, I'm sure it'll make a big explosion. Doesn't anything blow up around here? Lick the clock. The path is clear.
I'm detecting some nearby patrols.
I want to see if I can cause a distraction. Hold on. Blow up that console. It'll cause a nice distraction. Nog, how do I overload these ridiculous Iconian consoles?
Easy. First you need to... Wait. How are you at trinary conversions?
Never mind. I have a workaround.
Said it before, say it again. Lek is awesome.
Brother, you'll crack the safe. Once Brunt finds it, that is.
Nice of you to give me the easy job, Rom.
By that point, Lek will have eliminated their guards.
We're talking about Iconians here, Rom.
I'll be with you, Uncle. You'll be fine.
Oh, I feel so much better now. Time for me to earn my share. Watch and learn.
Don't worry, Uncle. I've got your back.
You know, you were supposed to shoot me if I got pulled into another one of these.
I thought you meant rescue operations. I can shoot you later if you'd like.
No, it just wouldn't be the same. I get the feeling Lek enjoys his job a little too much.
Yeah.
Maybe next time we shouldn't invite him. I'm not sure my stomach can handle it.
Ha! I'm impressed!
That's one word for it. He left some guard in the trophy room.
It's okay, Uncle. We can handle that.
All right, Nod, let's find the package. It has to be in one of the display cases around the room. Package located. The Sword of Kalos. Now, we need to retrieve it. I can use this to bring the package from its display globe. I need to use the right frequencies, though. Enter the wrong one, and every alarm around will go off. The frequencies change periodically. Once I start this, I need to get them all, or I'll have to start over.
I can just scan the machine for you. Should be easy enough to get the frequencies.
You, of all people, should know that Federation tricorders record whatever they scan. Never leave a data trail. We'll do this the Ferengi way. It'll take someone with the lobes for the job. That's me.
Nicely done, Uncle! We did it! We actually did it! We shouldn't stick around, though. Let's head back to the shuttle before the Iconians figure out what we're up to.
Rule 7. Keep your ears open and your eyes on the mark.
That's far enough. Well done, Quark. You actually managed to pull it off. I suppose I shouldn't be too surprised. You've a talent for larceny, after all. Time, however, is a factor. Hand it over now, or I'll shoot you both and take it from your cold, dead fingers.
Are you out of your mind? Have you forgotten who Nog and I are related to? No payout is worth what will happen to you if you do this. Rom will have every Eliminator, Bounty Hunter, and Pirate in the Four Quadrants gunning for you.
How did Lek put it? Oh, yes. The riskier the road, the greater the profit. Wise words indeed. The payout from this job will provide me with more than enough Latinum to remove your idiot brother and take my rightful place as the Grand Nagus. I'm willing to give you a sporting chance, however. Hand over the package. You might be able to flee before that very angry Iconian arrives.
Have it your way, Brunt. You're dumber than you look. If you think the crew of our ride won't be suspicious when you come back without us. They'll probably throw you in the brig on general principle. I know I would.
Ah, but I won't be traveling with them, Quark. I've made other travel arrangements. Time's up. Hand it over, or prepare to meet the blessed Exchequer. Ha! I'd pay a lot to witness that audit. Might even be worth dying for. just to hear you scream on your way to the vault of eternal destitution. Goodbye, Quark. At last, goodbye!
Nog, now!
Wait.
A force field? It will not stop me forever.
Look a little closer. That's a chronoton field. You might make it through, but it's definitely going to hurt. A lot. Or we can talk like sensible, intelligent people. Your call.
Very well. Speak. Your crimes are numerous. You breached my security, damaged my vessel, killed members of my crew, violated my sanctum, and stolen something very precious to me. Each is punishable by death. Tell me, why shouldn't I purge you by the odious vermin you are?
That's where you're wrong. I don't have anything of yours on me. Run a scan if you don't believe me. If anything, I was trying to stop the lunatic that did steal from you. I may be odious vermin, but I'm not stupid. Look, we should be working together to stop our mutual enemy instead of wasting time with this argument.
There will be plenty of time to eliminate each and every one of you filthy creatures. That field of yours will drop eventually, and then you will die. Your cohort will be trapped and ultimately killed. I will have my vengeance on you all soon enough.
You're not entirely wrong, but I think you're going to have a much bigger problem to deal with in the very near future. Any moment now. Remember this? A little something we picked up on Karema. Keep it on your ship and beam it to our location when we give you the signal.
What's that, Uncle?
Call it an insurance policy. You might make it through, but it's definitely gonna hurt. A lot. Or we can talk like sensible, intelligent people. Your call.
Explain yourself. Speak while you still can, Ferengi.
They're called Herc. Maybe you've heard of them. Real nasty dispositions. Eat everything they come across, and now they've come across your fleet. You Iconians are tough, but you're not invincible. Against the Fakiri and the Herc? Those are some pretty long odds to get. Here's how this is going to work. You're going to let us go, and in return, I'll disable the device that's bringing every Herc in the Quadrant here to chew on your ship. We'll go our way, you'll go yours. Otherwise, we'll wait and see what happens first. My field drops, or you and your ship become the main course at the Herc buffet.
I agree to your terms. Go! Get out! Leave my ship and disable your precious device. Know this. You've made an enemy today, Ferengi. I am patient. I will avenge myself. You will pay for your crimes.
Right. Then we have a deal. We'll be on our way then. I'll take care of your Herc problem once I've made it to a safe distance. I'd say it's been a pleasure, but we both know that'd be a lie.
Thank you.
waiting for? Run! Run! We're almost there, but we lost the sword! We went through all of this, and for what?
Quark to Modron. Is the package secured?
Modron here. You'll be happy to know the package is safe and sound. I beamed it to your ship a few minutes ago. I'm afraid Brunt is a little bruised, but these things happen. I'll keep him nice and sedated until we get back to the Alpha Quadrant. And Quark, be sure to let the Negus know I held up my end of the bargain, won't you?
I'll be sure to let him know, Modron. Quark out. Always have a backup plan, Nog. Especially when dealing with snakes like Brunt. Let's go.
And look, the shuttle's right where we left it. Things are looking up for a change.
Let's get out of here before T'Ket changes her mind. Thanks for sticking. Now, if you don't mind, let's get back to DS9. Very cranky Iconian looking for an excuse to kill us all. Rather not give them one more. Thankfully, she'll be busy dealing with the Herc. Garrick's little toy works like a charm.
We've got a problem. The cloaking device is acting up. If it goes down, every ship in the system will know we're here. I'll do what I can to keep it running, but we might need to fight our way out of here. Cloaks offline!
Terrific.
This is what I get for buying the jail.
Don't worry. I'll be running it again. I just need a couple minutes.
Where's Brunt?
Found another way back to DS9.
One more minute. Keep us safe.
Move out of range. Don't want anyone sensing our warp trail.
Cloak's online again, and we're at a safe distance from the enemy. We can leave as soon as you're ready.
I don't know about the rest of you, but I was ready to go the minute we warped into this system. And I'm doubly ready to go now. not to tell you your business, but make it so, please.
Quark and Nog told me you did a great job keeping them all safe. Thank you for bringing them back in one piece. The sixth rule of acquisition says, never allow family to stand in the way of opportunity. But what can I say? Family means a lot to me. There's something I'm curious about. The Herc stole the Sword of Kalis from the Klingons a long time ago, but no one seems to know why. They didn't eat it, so there must be something about it they value. And we Ferengi are all about value. Perhaps the lab's sensors and equipment can tell us more. Maybe it's made of a rare, precious metal.
Now, this is interesting. These readings indicate that the Sword of Kalis is made out of biological material with a germanium base. I'll need to run more tests to be certain, but I believe the weapon was fashioned out of a Herc carapace. This may explain their interest in it. Based on the scans, that carapace was around for quite a long time before Kalis made a weapon out of it. The blade material is over 4,000 years old, where the story of Kalis is roughly only 1,600 years old. What can I do for you? Well, he's got a deep contusion of the auricular lobe and a possible dislocated malleus. Normally, in a Ferengi, either condition could be fatal, but it seems that whoever did this to our friend here knew exactly how to keep the damage just this side of lethal. Luckily for the patient, he'll live. Unluckily, there's only so much modern medicine can do to numb this type of pain. Quark and Rom don't seem too concerned, though.
And they'll both pay for their crimes! Ah!
If you say so, Brunt, but the Grand Nagus has other ideas, I'm afraid. And I hear that Ferengi prison is unpleasant. None of the Ferengi were willing to tell me what led to Brunt looking like he went 10 rounds with the Gorn heavyweight champion. Care to enlighten me? I'm reading traces of multiple radiation types within the blade. Discounting the type that likely came from the Iconians, there are still clear traces of thermobaric and tetrionic radiation. I believe we could cross-reference Alliance and Dominion star charts and easily determine where these traces of radiation originated from. We have a 4,000-year-old weapon made of a Herc carapace. My analysis of the radiation within the blade should allow us to narrow down its point of origin. I've had the computer working on that as we speak. Let's have a look. Cross-referencing all known Alliance and Dominion star charts, and voila! There's one system that contains all of the conditions we've isolated. Havas Kul, at the edge of Dominion space. It's possible we've just discovered the location of the Herc homeworld. We should forward this information to the appropriate parties at once. This could be the breakthrough we've been looking for.
Sounds impressive and valuable. Rule 21, Quark. Never place friendship above profit.
Unbelievable! I knew Brunt was a snake, but Leck? Guess I should have known better. The bigger the smile, the sharper the knife. And Leck's got plenty of both.
He's a fool if he thinks he can steal from me! I'll have every Eliminator, Bounty Hunter, and Pirate in the four quadrants gunning for him! No one steals from the Grand Nagus and lives to profit from it!
Considering how angry my father is, the Klingons will be the least of Leck's problems. I haven't seen him this mad since he caught me... Well, we don't need to get into that. Despite everything that's happened, we'll hold up our end of the bargain. I'll be in touch when everything is prepared. And remember, this operation never happened.
Think they bought it?
Completely. As far as they're concerned, the sword has been stolen. You, might want to lay low for a while, though.
Opportunity plus instinct equals profit. Well done, brother.
The Sword of Kalis, as promised.
Once again, the House of Quark delivers. Martok will be pleased.
So will I, Grilka, once the payment clears. Pleasure doing business with you.
House Coat Gaming signing off.